Bros, oh my god, dude. that was a full stretch, no joke. How is everybody, man? How you guys doing? Yeah, my hair is very long and unmanageable right now, so I am getting a haircut later today. Should we just shave it all off? I wish I had the head shape for that. That would be awesome if I could just do that. That'd be so easy. If I look dope. Like, if I could cut my hair super short, like Gladiator style, like Russell Crowe in Gladiator, that would be so easy. We had a teacher growing up, Miss Skinner, and she shaved her head every day for like 15 years. I swear to God, like 15 years when you would see her, because older siblings had her and she had the same hair. Younger siblings would talk about, you know, that shit. Had the same haircut for like 15 years. It was so easy and manageable. Just would shave her head. And I was like, fuck yeah. Anyway. Thank you, Ari Bear. Oh shit, you got your wisdom teeth out yesterday? Hey, thanks for hanging with us still. I'm not shaving off all my hair, you wild, wild people. Come on, man. That's not gonna happen. I can't do it, dude. You guys like my dad title? Which ones are you cutting? All of them. Such a dad joke. You're trying to learn guitar right now, Katie Betts, 56? Any tips? Play along to stuff. If you're just starting, you need all the practice. Just play, 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 play. That is your new best friend. You're just going to play a lot. Listen to all kinds of music. Try to mimic it. Learn how to read. Learn music theory. Learn all that stuff. Leslie7793, thank you so much. Yeah, well, I'm sure your husband can pull it off. Thanks for rubbing it in, dude. No, I thanks, Blair at the Disco. Yeah, it's not floofy right now. It's greasy. Look at that. It's greasy. It's like falling. Not floofy, guys. But it's getting cut today, baby. Michaela Scalpello, thank you so much. Much love to you. Have a great day. Happy Weed Wednesdays, guys. Ari Bear, thank you so much for the bits. Yeah. The over-explained joke. That's like a very Ryan Reynolds thing. I love that. That's awesome. Thanks, Ari Bear. Maddie Burbank, thank you. How you doing? Yes. Because I know you do. How do you know that? Just because my brain is dope? You know that I can remember stuff. Masha, good morning. How are you? How you doing? Thank you. Polly, thanks. What's up? All the hairs? Yeah. Full body wax? No. Just the hairs on the head. I got a haircut. Which one did you cut? That's like every time I have something going on at 2:30 p.m. I won't tell Zach because he always does that stupid fucking joke. What time's your thing at? 2:30? Oh, is your dentist appointment? Silent Angel, thank you. Good morning. Becca Bear, thank you so much. Oh, that's awesome. Wow, that's kind of cool, though. A-Duck at 13, thank you. 50,000 bits for the dad joke. Hey, I appreciate that. Thank you. Sarah Jane, thank you so much, you guys. Oh, my God. And the bits are just flying in. I love Rachel. Morgan says, hi. Hello, Morgan. Dakari Yuri, thank you. Thank you, Meg Bunch of Numbers. Yeah, I'm getting the haircut later. In a couple hours. We're going to hang for 2 hours, and then I got to dip. Cindy Banal, thank you. Shaving the head? No. No, I'm not shaving my head, dude. Did Framework recover his gap? Come on, bro. Panic Leah, thank you. And his beautiful teeth. Oh, really? Yeah, they don't like that, do they? When you wash your hair before you go to the salon. Like, they want greasy hair because they want the satisfaction of cleaning it, I guess. I don't know. Thanks, Vera. Thank you, Maddie Burbank. What's up? Yeah, thanks, Maddie. Hi, I am a dog. Hello, thank you for the bits. Leslie7793, thank you so much. The Vietnamese. So listen, dude, if you guys don't know, me and my wife have been taking this like tincture oil, which is like THC CBD, at night. And it takes like an hour to kick in. And then like an hour in, you're just giggling, right? And we're watching the Chef's Line show. And if you don't know from yesterday, the Chef's Line show is amazing. And they focus on like one cuisine, right? So for like a week. So we had Vietnamese. And we were talking about, we're like, oh man, we got to try bun xeo. We got to try banh mi. We got to like eat some pho and all this stuff. We were talking about how much we love it. And she said Vietnamese. And that just made me die laughing. And then I would look at her and start crying laughing. And she would start crying laughing. And it just kind of elevated. Just kept escalating up. And we were just having a good old time, man. Thank God for weed. That's just a funny, cute thing that me and my wife do. Watch Chef's Line and fall in love with the food and then say dumb shit and laugh. Lexi Murdy, good morning. Thank you for the bits. Just Little B, thank you. Thank you, Aloha Sachi. How are you? Did you grow a mullet? Ooh, yikes. I used to have one when I was 4 years old. There's a picture out there somewhere. I didn't have any say in it, dude. I didn't know. I didn't know what the height of fashion was to that point. It was going to be mullets. Keith Kenny, thank you for the bits. Kelsey and Casey Jr. say hello. Hello, how are you guys doing? Love you guys. Thank you very much. Thanks, Ari Bear. Right, that you prefer to use their products? Interesting. Thank you, Maddie Burbank. Hello to Sarah. And can you say hi to Sarah? No. No, you can't. That's a straight up no. That's a fact. No, you can't. I don't know. Not here. Jenna Brand, thank you. What's up, man? To your sister, Adele. What's up, Adele? Lauren Milock, thank you so much. Simsley Marie, thanks for the 1,000. How you doing? You're on vacation? Oh, so dope. I'm doing great today. How are you? Hiding from a thunderstorm? Oh, no. Please be safe. As Jake Chams would say, please be safe. Malaka Busalama, thank you. Oh, damn. To Dubai Union Station? Go down to the market, man. There's that, like, big food plaza basically by the courthouse. I mean, it's like 4 blocks from the courthouse, but yeah, by the courthouse. They have awesome food stands, man. And they have a Golden Road brew down there. And that's also where I got my G&B coffee hat. There you go. Go get a hat. Bonsai, thank you. You're the bestest. Silly Green Oreos, thank you. Oh, yeah? Well, thanks for the invite. Thank you, Vera. I know. Dirty Rotten Scoundrels is so good, man. What a good movie. I mean, dude, Michael Caine, Steve Martin. Come on, man. Killer Queer, thank you. Hey, thanks for saying that. Stina, a.k.a. Havsty, Afifa Rizzi. Thank you both. Thank you, Olive Jus, 87. Thank you. Oh, hey. Hey, thanks for popping in. Vivki Sticky Palms. Yikes. Thank you. When are we touring in France next? I couldn't tell you because we don't have an album out yet. We're on break. We're taking a little break, a little breather. Maddie Burbank, thank you. Band wants popcorn. Yes, they do. Sam Wild, thanks for gifting the 5 subs to the community. That's so dope, dude. Thank you. You're awesome. Just another LA Bebo T. What's up? Good morning. How are you? Thanks, Jessica Bailey. Thank you, Casey Allison. Thank you, Gina Vro. Oh, eggs. Let's dope. Yeah, yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. Rohan Cadel. Rohan Cadel 08. Thank you so much. Morning from Australia. Oh, my God. It's got to be like 1 a.m. there, dude. Oh, damn. Cool tattoo ideas? Do the one where a squirrel is running up one leg and then he's running down holding a nut on the other leg. There you go. There's your tattoo idea. Please don't do that, by the way. Don't do that tattoo idea, please. A comedian mentioned that years back and I thought it was the funniest idea for a tattoo. Emily RKL, thank you. Hey, look, Mom just came on the radio. Oh, shit. Jenny Hexel, thank you so much. Oh, all good. Well, good luck with your travels. Please be safe. Sarah's Tab, thank you. Happy 13th birthday to your daughter, Jackie. What's up? Good morning. How you doing? Aloha, Sachi, thank you. Could you please read out loud? Sure. When Brennan streams, you can really see how he hasn't let fame get to him. Okay, man, dude. He's just buttering me up now. He's so down to earth, and he makes everybody feel like a friend. It's so rare in the music industry. We truly appreciate it. Love you, bro. Hey, I love you, too. Thanks for saying that. All right. You know, I'm here because I'm, A, I'm lazy, B, I'm selfish, and C, I don't have much I have to do today except get a haircut, so I figured, whatever. I'm up early because we're getting stuff work. Stuff work? No, we're getting work done on the house. Some stuff done to the house. Colorful chemistry, thank you. The people just show up early. They love to get here early and then get out of here early, which I back. So I'm up early. I'm like, come to my house early and finish the work and then goodbye. Thanks again, Colorful. Hey, thanks. Oh, no. Trishiri69, thank you so much. Oh, really? Hey, best of luck to you. All right, much love to you and the kids. Bakari Yuri, thank you. Yeah, she did. I'll settle for this username. Thank you. Hope you're having a great day, too. Alice94Crazy, thank you. Thanks, Sabrina. We're doing great today. How are you? Holy Spirit, thank you. Hello, Maddie Horton, what's up? Oh, yeah? Oh, don't ever apologize for that. Thank you for your donation. That's awesome. Emma underscore PATD, thank you. How are you? Annika, thank you for the bits. How you doing? Oh, really? We'll tell your mom thanks. Advanced Ghost, thanks. I've learned about 1 minute this is gospel. I'm proud of that. Hey, dope. Congrats. But I'm stuck at a part after that, and I can't seem to figure it out. Any tips? So you've learned the first minute. What part don't you know? It all repeats, by the way. There's only 3 parts of the song. Are you learning it on guitar or what? You're talking about piano? I need more specificity here. I don't know how to help you. Any tips? Just keep playing. Thank you, Akela222. Cousin getting married this weekend? Oh, yeah? What up, Ty and Josie? By the way, that's a great Blink song. Quinn Hoagie, thanks for the 1,000. Oh, my God. How you doing? It's been a minute. How you been? I'm doing great. I'm chilling. We got a couple hours chilling with the bros, you know. Taylor underscore 618. Thank you so much. What? Damn, dude. That's so cool. Wow. That's amazing, though. You got a Pell Grant, dude. That's amazing. Yo, massive congrats, Taylor. That's so cool. Seriously dope. You got a Pell Grant, bro. You're gonna cover your tuition. Go learn. Go learn, my bro. Be learned. All right, Bear, thank you. Oh my God, that's crazy. Weekly total donos already are $1,043. You guys are so wild, man. Thank you guys so much. In case you didn't know and you weren't aware, all of the money that comes into this stream right here with me and the Vros, every cent of it goes right to Highest Hopes Foundation. All right? So the money you give is going right to the nonprofit, and I appreciate you guys. Thank you for that, Curvy. I always forget we have those those commands. What's up? You're gonna get banned if you keep doing it, Soph. Polly, thank you. Oh, really? Yeah, you can horizontally flip it, because I've flipped mine, so it's a mirror. So it's not confusing when I try to explain where stuff is in my room. Thank you, Dakari Yuri. Virtual hug to you. What up? Thank you, Tessa. What up, Odd-Naren? Naren. You say Naren? Well, Mike, I'll tell you this right now. Mike says Naren, so you're saying it wrong. If anybody in if any British bros are saying Naren, that's not how Mike says it, but I'm sure he doesn't mind if you say Naren. I'm just letting you know how he says it. Like Naren. I don't know what you're talking about, Shea Baker, because we don't allow links or self-promoing here. Dylan Sage, thanks for the bits. How you doing? It's Emma's birthday today. Emma, you didn't say anything. Happy birthday, Emma. You freaking legend. Oh, come on. You guys, I love that you guys are telling me each other's birthdays. That's great. In SVL, thank you so much. Your mom's very strict and you're 20 years old. Well, your mom doesn't have any legal say, so go on your trip. You're 20 years old and you're letting your mom tell you what you can and can't do. I'm sorry, but if the thing is get out of my house or you follow my rules, I'm leaving the house, dude. I will find a way to sleep on any floor. Trust, okay? I ain't trying to be told what to do at 20 years old. You're 20 years old, you need to go do, how can I convince her? You don't need to convince your mom. You're 20 years old, go do what you want to do. Sorry, I'm just coming off so harsh if that's harsh, but like, you're 20 years old. Kids leave the home at younger. I think you should just go do what you're gonna do. Don't let your mom push you around anymore. Should have stopped at 18. Emily RKL, thank you so much for the bits. And she was just moving away from family. I'm looking to move to Nashville from Philly and hella nervous. Oh man, I was stoked. I love my family. I love being around my family, but I was so, so excited to leave my house and Vegas and see the world and go get into trouble and maybe be homeless for a little bit. I didn't know what was gonna happen. We didn't know what was gonna take off, what wasn't. And with that fear, I don't know, man. It drives you into a certain way, I don't know. Best of luck to you, and I think that that's a really cool move, dude. Nashville's dope. You're gonna have a blast. Great community there. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. Ooh, okay, weird flex. Dope. Abby Kadabi, thank you so much. Hope you're having a great day, too. Thank you. BL128, thank you so much. I suppose you can take all my... I feel you. LED12, thank you for gifting the 10 subs to the community. That is so kind, Ellie. Oh, man. Thank you so much. Abby likes pandas. Thank you for the bits. I love you. Thank you. Thanks, Becca Bear. How you doing? Wow, yeah, that's got to be terrifying. I'm sure that first leap is scary. But you got to go do you, man. Ari Bear, thank you so much. Oh, that's awesome, Ari Bear. Felicia at the disco, thank you. Is that real? I think I'm still known as the goddamn door guy, right? The goddamn door guy? I mean, that's funny. I'll take it, man. Steno Queen, thank you so much. What up, Zach Venture? What's up, man? What's up, bro? How you doing? Oh, wait, I did it backwards. Is that, I have to do like this, right? Is that the better way? Yeah, yeah, that's the right way. I have to do backwards. Nasir of Arabia, thank you so much. I own your heart. Thank you, Quinn Hoagie. Yeah? That's awesome. There you go. Madison Gooding goes, you should bring back the emo hair. Hey, I'm 32. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. That's awesome. That's great. Casey Allison, thank you. It's lit, boys. Sadie Stoker, thank you for the bits. Same, dude. There might be a couple other ones, so I have to say your full handle, right? Stale Potato 3, thank you very much. No, I'm not. I'm not leaving my house. Nell, thank you. Hi, cozy man. I'm very cozy right now. I'm ready for this haircut, I'll tell you that. It's just, it gets unmanageable at a certain point. When my hair gets to a certain length, right? So there's a few phases, right? There's short and clean, beautiful. Love that fresh cut. It feels awesome. You feel like $1 million walking out. You can wear different clothes and be like, ah, that's so great. Then there's the asshole phase, right? And that's the in-between. That's when you've had your haircut for a minute. It's been about a month and it grows into a shapeless mass on your head to where it's not long, but it doesn't have the same shape or effect that your haircut had the first week, right? That's asshole phase. Then you get to the point after asshole phase and that's, should I keep going phase? And that's the length I'm at now. I could keep growing it and it would just be so long and it would be Keanu Reeves long, but I'm not gonna do that. Because it's irritating, man. I don't wanna do that. I want the least amount of work possible. I'm lazy. So I'm getting it cut because it's easy. I get out of the shower, it dries quicker, and it's just floofy. Taylor_618, thank you so much. We used all kinds of different ones. Nell Michelle, thanks. Get a bowl cut? Yikes. Nasir of Arabia, thank you. I should stream me getting a haircut? Nah, dude. Nah. I'm not growing it. I'm cutting it. Ariel Hope 98, thank you for the bits. So according to my mom, I've brainwashed her with your music and she was doing her laundry and said had to have high heat for my linens. That's actually cute, dude. That's a good lyric change. I like that. For the linens, you know? Emma, happy birthday. Thank you for the 2,000 bits. It's your birthday, though, dude. Oh, man. Birthday biddies, thank you all so much for all the birthday wishes and love. You guys made me tear up. Thank you for making my teen years tolerable be. And here's to my roaring 20s. Love you fuckers so much. Happy birthday, Emma. We love you so much. Thank you. That's awesome. Oh, my God. Abby likes pandas. Thank you for the bits. Thank you, Michaela Scalpello. I'm feeling great, Abby. Thank you. I'm doing great. Thank you. Shaitin Coat, thanks. Curvy, I do the same thing. I have a friend come to my house and cut my hair. I haven't been to a salon in so long, dude. I tip my friend a little extra to come to the house so I don't have to leave my house. Thank you, Shaitin Coat. Thank you, I Love Rachel. Thank you, Viv Key Sticky Palms. Vicky Palmer, pick up the goddamn phone. There you go. Pawdoc, thank you. Bits for Emma's birthday. We love it. We're here for it. Capra Mori, thanks for the 420 bits. Happy Weed Wednesday, my dude. Brennan's Forehead, thank you for the bits. Can you read this out loud? I have a girlfriend. I am a girl, too, and I am bisexual, and she is a lesbian. And we are telling all of our classmates that we are dating on the first day of school, and I would love it if you could be a part of it and say, Zoe and Charlotte are dating. Also, this Saturday, me and my family are going to Hawaii. This is my first time going. And I'm really excited. Hey, that's awesome. Also, yesterday, I got my band was popcorn t-shirt. Hey, that's so dope, dude. Good luck at school. You don't need to worry about anybody else. You guys are going to be all good. Okay. Ty, not Tyler. Thanks for the bits. How are you? How many bits for you to eventually sing This Is Gospel on stream? Will shit. 10 out of 10. My going rate is $1 million a show. There you go. 7:04 o'clock. Thank you so much. There's a wasp in my room. Wish me luck. Oh my God. Best of luck. Please be safe. Ari Bear, thank you. I'll smoke some for you, Ari Bear. Beauty of the Lake, thanks for the bits. Want to wish you all an awesome day. Ask a huge favor for love, light, and virtual hugs. Please, no sympathy. We're sorry for your loss. Oh, wow. I'm so sorry to hear that. All right. Sending you all the love, Beauty of the Lake. I'm here for Brendan. Thank you. No. Thanks, Emma. Make a bunch of numbers. Thank you. And all the birthday love to Emma. Look at that. There you go. Oh my God, Steffi appreciates me. That's awesome. 4 months. Oh my God. Nice. Avery loves PATD. Thank you very much. Casey Allison, 37. Thank you. You're trying to live the dream right now? Live that dream. Ty Not Tyler, thank you. Hey, love you, Ty Not Tyler. It's all good. Much love to you. Thanks, Podoc. I'll always pay a little extra if I don't have to leave my house, dude. Isn't that our whole lifestyle now? That's all of the world now. Because we have Postmates and all these things. Instacart and whatnot. Dude, you literally don't ever have to leave your house. That's scary. That's scary. Everybody has their own lair. Everybody has their own evil lair. Because everything's at your fingertips. Killer Queer, thank you for the bits. Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, you got me that shirt? That's awesome, man. Thank you so much for that. Yeah, Killer Queer, thank you. I wore the shit out of that thing. Emma, thank you for the bits. Appreciate you so much, too. Vivki Sticky Palms, thanks. Legal Heartbreaker, thank you. Hey, thanks for joining the party and lurking. It's all good. Yeah, if you don't ever leave your house, you don't ever have to wear clothes. Life hack. It's coffee, though, you know? How do you cope with creative block? I walk away from it, voice on the street. I literally walk away from it and go do something else. I'll stand up, walk, play a video game, anything that takes my mind away from what I was doing so I can come back fresh. Fresh. Fresh.
Fresh. Cafeteria fresh.
Gina Vro, thank you so much for the bits. Yeah. Dude, I just watched that South Park, the Jeff Bezos one. The Amazon delivery one. That's so funny. Thank you, Silence. Advice when people tell you that your work is a POS. So far, I've been saying out loud or otherwise to fuck off, and I'm happy with my work, but it's starting to get to me. Cult leader, wise words, please. Yeah, I don't give a shit, dude. Like, I put a song out, and people were shitting. Like, I didn't even put a song out. Check this out. I made that metal song, right? And I showed the Vros on stream. And people still shit on it. Guess who doesn't care? I don't know, man. Like, that shit doesn't get to me when people talk about my art. Because I don't take it seriously. I don't know. Like, I love my music. I love that I get to do that. But I don't even take it seriously. It's not like, listen to my art piece. Listen to this song. It totally describes who I am. Like, it's a fucking song, dude. About some stuff I was going through. So what? If they read a diary entry of mine and started shitting on it, I'd be like, have the same vibes. I'd be like, okay, I didn't write it for you. Wrote it because I needed to write that for me. Glad you liked it. That's awesome. Appreciate it. You don't like it? Couldn't care less. I don't know, man. I just don't care about that stuff. A lot of times I'll go and seek it out because I find it hilarious. Like bad comments, like mean, rude comments make me laugh because I think about somebody wasted their time and energy writing that, you know? You have to just laugh it off. Sarah K. Superstar, thank you. How you doing? Thanks, Grace Rudolph. Thank you, Quinn Hoagie. You not want to leave because you're chilling? Or because you get recognized out in public? Both, I mean. I don't really care about the getting recognized stuff. I'm just honestly chilling in my house. I haven't had this much time ever in my life. Like off from doing work. So I'm just stoked. It's really cool, actually. And I've been doing a lot of just chilling. Polly, thank you for the bits. Thank you, Perfectly Panic. Thank you, Aloha Sachi. Claire Gillespie, thank you for the bits. Oh my God. That's so awesome. Congrats and thank you. Big love to you. So dope. Chai Tin Ko, thank you. Hi to your friend, Anne. What up, Anne? Much love to you. That is so Slytherin. Yeah, I guess so, right? Because I don't really care. I don't really give a shit. what people say. Trish Yuri, thank you very much. Like, I'm here for the positivity. I'm here to, like, share advice and constructive criticism. But when people just shit on your stuff, it kind of makes me laugh. I don't know. Maybe that's rare. I don't think a lot of... I don't know. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thanks again. Yeah. Nell, thanks. Your work's a piece of shit. Now I'm $1.40 in the hole as I try to get noticed for saying something inflammatory. To get people talking, even though they're going to forget about this in a week when you do something else. Oof, too much? Yo, Nell, that's exactly what I'm saying. Right? That's so true. Like, you wasted money and time to... Or just effort. And if time is money, then you did waste money. If you wasted your time saying stuff, you could have gone and made $5. Coffee Devotee Leslie, thanks for the bits. Thank you, Jenny Sunshine 34. Appreciate ya. Oh, happy birthday, Emma. Yeah, we love it. Oh, hey, happy late birthday, Jenny Sunshine. Oh, man. Carmi, good morning. Thank you. Sarah Panic, you can have that mentality today. You just have to change. There's a comedian and mentalist and entertainer who's Darren Brown, and he says, the only reason we feel the way we feel about ourselves is because every day we tell ourselves a story about who we are as individuals. So if you start to change your story and be more honest with yourself about who you actually are, I think you'll start to realize you're more impressive than you think, and you're cooler than you really think that you are right now. That's just how it's going to be. Ari Bear, thanks again. Oh, that's so cute. That was you, Ari Bear. Thank you very much. Thank you, Sam Roush. Yeah, joke's on them. Yeah, totally. But even in those moments, it's like, I could care less. When, you know, people are like, are you this? Are you that? You're like, this is not a conversation I want to have because you seem like you suck. We don't have conversations with shitty people because they don't want to converse. They just want to throw bullshit at you. That's not fun. Sarah K. Superstar, thank you again. That was awesome yesterday. That was so cool. Velvet Fright, thanks for the bits. Yep, good morning. Oh, thank you. Gina Bro, thanks for the bits. Oh my god, B equals Dr. Phil. Nope. Your internet dialogue is everything. Yeah, man, I just don't care. Hey. That actually applies to you too, B. Appreciate yourself more. Oh, I appreciate the shit out of myself. You don't have to worry about me. If anybody's got a fucking biggest fan ever, it's me of myself. You don't have to worry about that. I don't have an inflated sense of self, but I have a very sturdy self-respect. Okay. Claire Gillespie, thank you for the bits. I've never been hypnotized. Someone's tried before, yeah. Yeah, that one's cool, right? Yeah, Darren Brown's awesome, man. He's really entertaining. Thank you, Creative Wanderer. By the way, Claire, you know that that's like a mentalism trick, right? Because he says it in the beginning of his spiel, of his whole show. He says, I'm a mentalist. This is a trick. I am tricking you. This is not some deity coming down from the heavens and telling me about your life. And people still believe that he was of God and doing wild shit. How crazy is that? That's like actual insanity. When it's explained to you and you still go, nah, that's the Louis C.K. joke, you know? And okay, triggered, problematic, whatever. Fuck you guys. Louis C.K. still has a joke that's amazing. And he says, this is America in a nutshell. Christopher Columbus shows up to the Americas and goes, you guys are Indians, right? And they go, no, we're Native Americans. He goes, ah, you're Indians. So America, that's 100% now just the internet. America has changed everyone for the worse with fast food and the internet. Ah! Yeah, man. Silence, thanks for the bits. This is what is called pontification. I'm literally spewing out bullshit that I may or may not think is true. And you'll never know if I actually do. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. Aside from music and gaming, are there any other hobbies you enjoy often, B? I mean, those are the top two. Music and gaming, for sure, my top ones. I enjoy cooking with my wife. We enjoy making dinner together. I very much enjoy food. Food is definitely one of my top five hobbies and passions. I love it. Simsley Marie, thank you so much. And then the other one I have to say is mixology, alcohol, all that stuff. Quinn Hoagie, thank you for the 1,000. Simsley, thanks for gifting those subs. Wise Wednesdays, nah, dude. Tanya Green 14, thank you for the bits. Thank you, Lexi Murdy. Oh, that's so cool. Oh, don't know. I hope you're okay. At least it was just the drum head, right? It's not too heavy. Yeah, dude. Casey Allison, those are cute, right? The emotes. Thanks to Hype Annika, who made those. All the new emotes, man. I'm so here for them, dude. I love them so much. Like, look at these, dude. They're so dope. Look at all these new ones, man. Look at that. It's so cool. That is the coolest right there. Very, very cool. Thanks, the Twitch spy. That's awesome. Thanks for doing that. Oh, man. Everybody vote for Taylor. VMAs, not me. Just vote for Taylor. I'm a part of it, but we're voting for Taylor. Fulton Charles 811. Thank you so much. Oh, my God. Hey, best of luck to you. From Wales? Oh, my God. Meg, bunch of numbers. Thanks again. Sari is a goddess. Yeah, she lets me help. Like, I'm the kid in the Shake and Bake commercial. And I help. Like, that's me when Sarah's cooking. I go, what can I do? You need help? Yeah, can you do that? Okay. And it's like the smallest task ever. But I'm here for it. And I'm so proud of myself when I do it. Okay, I did it. Yeah, a special stool to stand under the kitchen. Dude, that was the shit when you were a kid. Remember that? I remember being 4 years old and my mom teaching me how to make a peanut butter and jelly. At 4 years old, before I even went to kindergarten, she taught me how to make a sandwich. And I felt like such a big kid. I remember making it myself. Granted, she didn't let me use the silverware until I was like eight. But still, with plasticware in hand, I made myself a PBJ. Bonze842, thank you so much. PBJ. You just got a job offer? Dope, dude. Big congrats to you. Karen B0314, thank you. Yeah, dude. Tiny0401, thank you very much. I'm not answering that. Gets me into trouble. Legal Heartbreaker, thank you so much. Wait, what do you say? First year of school is open. Nervous as fuck. Oh, I see, I see. I know no one and I have to go first day tomorrow. Any advice on how to navigate that sort of deal? Perhaps just some Yuri motivation? Well, I'll tell you this. Any high school is going to be pretty similar. And I know that because I had been to a couple different high schools. All my siblings went to different high schools than I did. And there was a take your sibling to school day for my older brother. And he took me. It was such a move because all these girls thought I was adorable. And he got so many points and so many girls hit on him after that. And I mean, he's also just a good looking dude. So he didn't need my help, but it definitely upped the points a little bit. Right. And that high school was cool. And then I compared it to the high school I went to and it was different. I went to a high school that was a little more like preppy, rich kids. And it was still the same. Everybody acts the same. So if you're nervous about going to a new school, I'll say this. They're going to be just as immature as they were in middle school, just as immature as the last high school you went to. Everybody's going to be just as lame. You might meet a cool teacher. It's going to be a pretty similar experience. So best of luck to you, but I got full faith in you. Vera, thank you for the bits. Thank you, Sax Kids. That's funny. I haven't even honestly thought about that, so I can't give you an honest answer. Sorry. I'm not even thinking about it. I'm not even thinking about Tor yet. Are you being hyperbolic, Misty the Mist? Or is that real? Because you know that's real stuff. Meg, bunch of numbers. Thank you. Get that step stool, dude. It's all good. Do I like playing at festivals? I love playing at festivals, man. It's different than your own headline show and tour. And it's almost like a point of pride to me, to like I have to go prove myself kind of show. Because festivals, a lot of times, it's not just your fans. It's people that are there to see another band, especially if you're not headlining the show. Which it's been a minute since we've, not weird flex, but since we've not headlined a festival. But when you do, you're playing to just different people. And I like to take it on and be like, all right, we're going to show you what the fuck Panic brings to the table. Here we go. You ready for this? Oh, you've heard of our band? Yeah, you'll remember it after today. And that's kind of what I like to do. Kayla222, thank you for the bits. And much love to you too. I'm sorry that you're having a rough day, but we're sending you all this love, okay? Feel better, Kayla, okay? Much love and giant hugs to you. What's up, my bros? What's up, everybody? It's been 40 minutes. 40 minutes up into the piece. Dude, I was telling my wife yesterday, she's like, I've noticed like you haven't, have you been playing games lately? I'm like, no, I haven't played Fortnite in like a couple weeks now. Maybe once in the last couple weeks. It's weird. I'm kind of missing it a little bit, but at the same time, I'm like, it's been a nice little breather. Because that's all I was doing for the longest time. That's dope, dude. 38 days till Music Midtown. I better start getting back in shape. Blair the Disco, thank you for the bits. For real. Daniel 24, thank you. Nice. Yeah, that's demon. What do you do when you're upset? I do a bunch of different things, Shazza. I don't know. Short stream today? Yep, it's only going to be 2 hours. Because I'm getting my hair cut. Brennan, do you have any tips for new singers who want to be like you? Also, what are some of the hardest panic songs to sing? Thank you so much. Any tips for singers who want to be like me? If you want to be like me, that's not a good place to start for a singer. I'd say if you want to be a good singer, you should go and seek it out. You should go talk to different vocal coaches, take different vocal lessons, read a bunch of books about it. You should actually study it. I did not do that. But any chance I get, I do like to talk to people about it, you know, but I don't think I'm the best person to mimic. I'll say the more that you do it, the better you get at it. They say 10,000 hours of doing something makes you a professional, right? So, yeah, I hope that helps. I'm sorry. I don't know. Felicia at the Disco, thank you for the bits. Thank you, Meg Bunch of Numbers. Oh, that's awesome. So what, dude? I'll eat ramen and McDonald's every day too. Seriously. That sounds so fire right now. Karen BO314, thank you very much. Oh my god. Oh, don't be nervous. It's all good. Robin, thank you. These are for my dad Ron. He wants to know if you've ever watched the Face Your Fears videos on VR. I have. I saw the Stranger Things one, the spiders one, the ghost one. Yeah, those are funny. I like those ones. The catatonic thing though on the Within app on your Oculus is dope, dude. I hope it's still out there. That was like years ago that we did that. It had to be like 4 years ago, maybe more, that we did that. So maybe it's not even a thing anymore. Emily RKL, thank you for the 1,000 bits. So back to me moving to Nashville. I got a relationship. It's like something I have to do. Of course. Hey, you do you, man. Take care of yourself. Mia Sharon, thank you. Oh my god, I want a Pokeball too. That sounds fire. Marshmallow 334, thank you so much for the bits. Okay. Uh-huh. Yeah, that was me and the director talking ideas. We wanted to connect three videos, so it was loosely talked about, and then it was just a matter of connecting those things once we got the first one done. So yeah. It was kind of mix and match situation. Linda Panic, thank you. How you doing? Goodbye, greasy long hair. I know, dude. Oh my god. DBD mindful. Abby Kadabi 720, thank you so much. Love ya. Thanks, Reese's Babe 101. Appreciate ya. Oh yeah. Hey, best of luck to you. I hope it works out. Get that figured out. Fulton Charles 811, thank you very much. Oh, that's funny. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you. Oh, I love ramen, dude. I'll eat it all day. Oh, you're talking Maruchan ramen. Not like legit. Okay, got you. Nocturnal Muse, thank you for gifting the community 5 subs, dude. That's so dope of you. Thank you, Nocturnal. How you doing? Vitamin. Do I have a favorite candy? I mean, I always say Reese's Peanut Butter Cups just because it's the shit, but I'll take a Snickers too any day. Charmaine, thank you for the bits. Hello. Hey, best of luck. Best of luck to you, okay? On your presentation. Thank you, Shelby Lynn. Oh my God. Oh, dude, I'll tell you, I was so excited to hit 30 years old. Because my friends were all like, dude, you're going to be 30 soon. Like, what do you think? Oh my God, you're turning 30? What are your thoughts? And I was like, dude, I'm stoked. I think that I'm just going to become more who I am. That I'm going to give less fucks. And I'm just going to be more me. And it totally was that. I turned 30. I was like, oh, this is 30? Dope. Okay. I'm just more myself. Polly, thanks for the bits. Sure. Oh, geez. That's funny. Oh, my God. I know, Kirby. That's the move. People don't know. Reese's peanut butter cups in, like, cookie dough ice cream. Oh, bro. If you freeze Reese's peanut butter cups, by the way, it's so dope. Because it's still, like, a soft inside. Trishuri69, thank you so much. Sugar Rose, is that your strip club? Casey Mori, thank you. Ooh. Highest score I've ever gotten from bowling? Dude, I think I got lucky one time and broke 200, which is ridiculous. But I think that might have been once in my life. I'm happy if I get like a 150. You understand? If I break 100, I'm stoked in bowling. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. We used to live off that ramen every day. Because, dude, it's like 10 cents a pack. We'd buy it in bulk in like pallets for like $5 for 100 packs of ramen. Literally, dude, we were making the first album. We were living off of ramen and Pop-Tarts. That was pretty much it, man. Oh, once in a while, I remember like twice that whole trip. One time we went to Moe's Grill, Mexican Grill, and it was so good. We were losing our minds. Then we found this little deli that had $1.50 subs. We couldn't believe what we were seeing. It was also College Park, Maryland, so it was college town, like cheaper stuff anyway. And coming from Vegas, where you usually have cheap food, we were so stoked to see a $1.50 sandwich. Oh, we ate the shit out of it, dude. Sarah K. Superstar, thank you for the bits. Yenny Konamore, thank you so much. Yeah, man. It's the best. Marshmallow 334, thank you. Thank you, Jazzy J. Thank you very much, guys. Marshmallow, how do I get out of them? I listen to music most of the time when I'm feeling like really down. Usually music gets me out of it or puts me more further into it. Like if I'm feeling sad, sometimes a sad song will make me feel more validated in my sadness, if that makes any sense. So I'll do that. But then other times it'll be good to listen to like the Daz Band or something and just rock out, bounce. Just fun. Marco Polo 24, thank you for the bits. Oh, I heard about this. Yes. Yeah, I heard about that. I mourned. She was very sweet. Shared a beautiful couple hugs. Rest in peace. Rest in peace, my bro. Oh, that's nice. Live life and love life. Great name, by the way. Music is a healer, dude. Why are y'all coming for me? Wait, who's coming for you, Kate? What'd you say? Oh, Jesus. That's what you said. Get out of here. Thanks, Kirby. Are they? I'm bony, dude. I have a bony chest, bony shoulders. My wife reminds me constantly. I'm trying to plump myself up so she doesn't think I'm so bony. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you. No, it's just up here, dude. A bony upper body, man. Shoulders and clavicle and chest, they're all, you know, skinny bones. Ari Bear, thank you. Really? That's awesome. I'm all for a good gas station food, man. Do we have a song of the day theme, guys? What's up? I didn't even see it. Reading all these amazing bros donations. Thanks, Gina Vro. Right. That's true. I mean, protein's just a thing, but yeah, it's not a food, but yeah. What's your favorite food? Protein. Music that motivates you. Love it. That's the theme, guys. All right, so send in your suggestions, okay? Best Pones, thanks for the bits. Hey, have a nice day, too. Thanks, Best Pones. Thank you. No, Michelle, thank you again. Might be late to the topic. Yeah, I really don't have any fucks left to give. I feel that. Yeah, the title, dude. I know. I'm sad. Sky Panics, thank you for the bits. Okay. Trish Yuri 69, thank you. I am the lucky one for sure. Sarah K Superstar, thank you. Oh no. Okay, you have a great day too, Sarah K Superstar. Feel better. Thanks, Ice Heart Mac. We do have a song theme. It's music that motivates you guys. I.e., could be the Rocky theme song. It could be anything that motivates you. I mean, I just went there because that's the classic, right? Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you. It's fine. Claire Gillespie, thank you. I'm curious to hear your skincare routine. I FaceTime my twin, Netflix, with some wine joint and treat my face to some Kiehl's masks. Yeah, so I use Kiehl's too and Dermalogica. So I use Kiehl's, the moisturizer, just for my face after I've washed it. And then I use this under eye cream by Dermalogica. That's it. That's literally it. That's all I do. I wash my face with Kiehl's in the shower. And then I do that. And I moisturize and put a cream under my eye. But it's not a lot. Like, you put a dab on your ring finger because it's the softest pads of your fingers. Didn't know that, did you? Then you do that. Gotta take care of yourself. It's better if your fingers are cold, too. It's better for your skin. Thank you, Sax Kids. That's a great one, actually. Fulton Charles 811, thank you so much. Yeah, I mean, Blur song number two, Tub Thumpin', Chumbawamba, you know. Thanks, Fulton. Ariel Hope 98, thank you so much. Yes, I know. I mean, I don't think I even fully understand it. I would say don't beat yourself up about it. You're fine. You don't have to, by the way. You don't have to leave your house. Anna Gabby C, thank you so much. How much do you pay your therapist? Polly, thank you. Ah, gotcha. Gotcha. Nice. Sarah did tell me all that. And our friend Jeremy. They're both estheticians, so... and cosmetologists. They both have a license. They're both licensed cosmetologists and estheticians. So, there you go. Sarah helps all our friends, and she does, like, private sessions for people. She'll, like, help them shop for stuff, take them to the pro store, do all that stuff. And, yeah, man. That's the only reason I know all this stuff. Because she gave me two things. She's like, listen, you don't need a lot, asshole. But moisturize your face and then put an under eye cream, and you're going to be fine. Just do that. And I've actually been slacking a lot on it. So, apologies to my lady. And to all of you. For not keeping up my skincare routine. Oh, God. Sorry. Thanks, Ari Bear. Yes. Jeremy Kaikala. Yes. Kaikala. Use sunscreen every day. Every day I go out in the sun, I use sunscreen. 100%. 30 to 50 SPF. Have to. You're so dramatic. Am I? Yeah, dude. What's up, baggy? Curvy, tomorrow's your 11th wedding anniversary. That's so dope, dude. Oh, that's great. Transatlanticism, great album, by the way. Cena Panic, thank you so much. I'm doing great today. How are you? I really am, man. I feel great today. We were having a great time yesterday, too. My lights are freaking out. Because I live in LA and we have brownouts all the time. Um, Yes, Sean Thomas Prime 1. I have played God of War. I love those games. I haven't played the newest one where you teach your son. But yeah, I'm down. Is it on PC? I thought it was just a PlayStation game. Why is everybody married in this chat? Because we're son love. Because we found our soulmates. Where did I get my earbuds from? A company that we use for our stage in-ear monitors. They're called Ultimate Ears. UE. And they're phenomenal, dude. We've used them for the last 14 years. They're just so good. Truly. Truly. Maybe 13 years, 14 years. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, dude. I love these. And they have the Vro crew symbol on them. But yeah, Ultimate Ears, man. They're amazing. They're not cheap, but they're worth it. Saves your hearing and everything sounds amazing. How often do I use face masks? I never do that. Wow. I should though, huh? I'm not opposed. I just never think about that. Yeah, it's PlayStation 4 exclusive. Yeah, see, my PlayStation broke, so I still have to buy one. Trishier69, thank you so much. Because of consistency errors. Because somebody messed up. No, honestly, the blood sprayed for real and it just didn't get on my undershirt. It didn't bleed through for some reason. The dress shirt just soaked it up and that was it. Or vice versa. The one shirt just got hit and the other one didn't. So that's what happened. And we just left it on like that. What's up? Go fix your PlayStation? No. You don't understand. It broke. Like, you can't turn it on anymore, so I threw it in the trash. There was no saving it. Trust. Strawberry Mermaid, thank you. It was old. It was old. It was like 10 years old. It was old. It was very old. I think I got it in like 2010, maybe? 2011? So yeah, it was almost a decade old. But I also didn't take very good care of it. Like, I put stuff on top of it. I.e. drinks and stuff. Dr. Tail, thanks for donating the money, Maeva. Okay. Welcome to the game. And if you haven't, FNAF. Also, if you watch this, I have not. Thank you very much, Dr. Tail. Thanks, Strawberry Mermaid. UE? I actually don't know where they're based. Where are they based? I thought they were East Coast. Oh, they're Irvine. There you go. It's been so long since I've gotten my molds done down there that I didn't even realize. Yeah, they're Irvine. Yeah, it is California. Yeah, dude, Ultimate Ears is dope. We still pay for them. Like, they don't even give us money. What up, Velvet Fright? Thank you very much. Oh, wow, that's awesome. That's cool. Thank you. Nocturnal News, thanks for gifting the 5 subs to the community. That's so dope, dude. Thank you. That's awesome, Emma. I don't have that. Yeah, dude. I need to buy another PlayStation. Dude. That's wild, Nocturnal. You have gifted 453 to this channel in total. You are a legend. Thanks, Yenny Konamor. Oh, you know what it would be. You know it would be lemon verbena. Yeah, exactly. You know it would be that. For sure. It would smell like lemongrass in heaven. Oh, man. We've missed you, Nocturnal Muse, so much. Thanks for popping in. You're so dope, dude. Oh, I'm almost done with my coffee. There's like 2 sips left. I'm gonna go vote on these songs. Oh, man. Wow, I don't know a lot of these songs. Again. Well, I'll do one of the three that I know. There we go. Oh, nice. Mine's not even close to winning. It never is. I love it. Thank you, Yeniko Namur. Thanks again. Thanks, Sax Kids. Everyone vote. Emily RKL, thank you again. Hey, what? It's all good. Mary Elizabeth, thank you for the bits. Thanks. It's okay. Thanks for popping in, though. Making time. Cinepanic, thank you. Hey, thanks. Hey, you're wonderful, okay? Nell Michelle, thanks again. Yeah, that's what you were gonna pick. What did you, you know what I picked? We'll be singing and we're winning. That's what I picked. You know it. What's up, okay? What's up, okay? I was surprised that some of those songs were on there. I was like, that's a motivation song? Interesting. I'm not opposed. I just never thought of it like that before. I was like, oh, I guess so. That's cool. That's cool, man. It's definitely winning. Yeah, for sure. Sax Kids, thanks again. I know we're not going to win. It's so good. It's in the night away. Oh, my Lanza. Julie Jackson, thank you very much. I want to say thanks. Hey, thank you. Polly, thank you. Exactly. Yeah, I had an invite, actually, Curvy. I had an invite a couple months back. And was like, yo, you want to go? I was like, no, I'm okay. It seems fine. I just don't want to leave my house. Also, they stream it live. So it's like I could just watch it from my house. Zoe Pal, thank you. You know that, right, Curvy? You can watch it live. Pretty crazy. I did not get my hair cut. I'm getting it done after the stream. That's why I wanted to get on early today, because in an hour I'm gonna go get my hair cut. Thanks, Zoe Pal. Long hair. No, dude, cutting it. Oh my god, it's so greasy. Oh, when it's past my nose, that's when it's, yeah, time. It's time, dude. Nice, Nell. Thanks, Cinepanic. Can you marry my voice? That's very sweet. Thank you. Where do I get my haircut? At my house. I have a friend come to my house. A friend who has a cosmetology license comes to my house and cuts my hair. Anna's 4444. Thank you for the bits. But I pay extra to make it worth their while, because they have to drive like 2 miles out of their way. And so I say, hey, I'll throw you a little extra. Come to the house and trim it. So that I literally don't have to worry about putting a shirt on. I sit there shirtless while they cut it, and then I run up to the shower and I just wash it out. I rinse it out, I mean. I'm gonna have to wash it before they cut it, though. Sax Kids, thank you. Your haircut live on stream. No! Britt J, thank you. All right, stay dope. Have a great day adulting. Please be safe. Reverse mohawk, what would that be? You mean just having this? What's a reverse mohawk? You just shave the middle, that's it. Shaitan Coat, thank you so much. Okay, interesting, interesting. Yenny Konamor, thank you. Oh, I see. That's cute. Yeah, nice. I like it. Cut it shorter, Death of a Bachelor era, do it. I'm just gonna trim it, dude. Literally, I'm just gonna say, just get the hair off the sides of my head and get the top of the hair short enough to where it's not in my face. That's all I want. That's how they do it. What up, Dark Storm? Everyone stay safe out there, my dudes. What can be scary sometimes? We got this with the power of love. That's the power of love. Thank you, Dark Storm. Appreciate you. Dude. So I was walking out to the studio last night to smoke a joint. And as I'm walking here, I see four, not three, not two, not one, four massive spiders, literally about this big, huge, each one of them, massive. Like, that's just the body, right? Big spiders chilling. And so I didn't smoke weed because they were all coming over the door. Like, they were building webs into the door of my studio. I came out here, they were all gone, but dude, they were huge. And I was like, fuck that. I'll hit my pen. I'm good. Thank you, Gina Vro. Till mañana. All right, we'll see you. Hasta mañana. Thank you, Cinepanic. Can I sing? Yes, I can. It's my job. Mm-hmm. How being high feels. What, Sarah Panic? You're curious? It's hard to describe. If you've never had sex, it's hard to describe. So if you've had sex, to me, it's like the afterglow. That moment after everybody's finished and you're just laying there cuddling. You're just like, that's how being high feels to me. Tingly. Yeah, exactly. No. It's like somebody took a warm blanket and wrapped it around my head when I smoke weed. And then put a warm blanket behind my eyes. So I'm just like, if that makes sense. That's how I feel. Can't you smoke somewhere else? Yeah, but my weed is in the studio because I don't like my house to just smell like drugs. I like to separate it because I like to have people at my house and host parties and stuff. But I like the house to stay clean, you know? So professional. You understand? Yeah, a blanket, exactly. Sugar Girl 90, thank you for the bits. After everybody's finished? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Climax. I love spiders. What's so bad about them? Nothing. I just don't want them crawling around my hoodie while I'm trying to go to bed. You understand? Cinepanic, thank you. Can sing. I love you, Cine. Yeah, I can sing. It's my job. You know I'm fucking with you, right? Because you're asking it that way? All right. Sadad, right? So your studio smells like weed? Yep. Every time my friends come over to the house and they want to, hey, let's see your studio. I open up the door and they're just like, whoa. It smells like so much weed in here. It's my favorite. Weed and lemon verbena, dude. I am considerate about my house not smelling like weed. How much more adult can you be, dude, you know? I rarely smoke it in the studio here. Maybe when I'm gaming and I don't want to leave, I'll smoke a joint in here. But most of the time, I'm smoking outside. I'll roll it in here, and all the fresh weed is in the studio. But I like to smoke it outside. And, like, even when I smoked cigarettes, I never smoked in the bar where you were allowed to smoke. Because I thought it was fucking gross, dude. Even when I was a smoker, I never thought that was fun. I don't want to sit in a fucking cloud. Even when I smoke a cigar, I don't want to sit in a fucking lounge with no ventilation and get covered in cigar smoke. It's gross. It's fun to smoke, and it smells great when you're smoking outside, but when you're stuck in a cloud of it, bro, it sucks. Thank you, Trishuri69. Yeah. Exactly. Thank you, Sam Roush. Yeah, right? Total Thundershirt vibes when you get high, for sure. I feel that. Thank you, Emily RKL. What? That's dope. Thank you, Simsley Marie. Thanks so much. Please read out loud. I hope everyone in this chat and whoever rewatches this knows that they're loved, appreciated, beautiful, and all around amazing people who deserve everything good in their life. Yeah. I love this community and all the bros so much, and I just want you all to know that you are worth it. Thank you, Slimsy Marie. Couldn't agree more. Thank you. Thanks, Meg Bunch of Numbers. Please read. Spelchy, Christy Blue Eyes, High Heeled Sinner, and I all want you to know how amazing you are. You have such a big fucking heart. Oh, thank you. We just appreciate you and all that you do. Thank you. I don't want to read this aloud. It's just building me up. Hey, thanks for saying that, though. I appreciate you and love you, too. Thank you. I don't want to read compliments about myself. I appreciate it. I'm taking it all. Putting it here in my heart. Thank you very much for saying that. Vera, thank you. It's up to you, Vera. No one's going to tell you what to do. You do you, baby. Oh, yeah. Of course. Yes, Kirby. Yes, I've broken things because it was covered in resin. Like microphones and stuff, dude. Ugh. You know? I know. Yeah, I've hotboxed this. Dude, all during Pray for the Wicked, this room, you could barely see through the glass of smoke, dude. It was so hotboxed. And all my friends were in here, and I kept saying, I was like, guys, I'm sorry. Like, I'm not going to smoke in here. They're like, dude, smoke. You do you. We're in your space. Like, you do you. And so they let me just keep smoking, and they would just leave, like, secondhand high. I kind of felt bad. But it was fine. Oh, man. Okay, Jonah not reading compliments anymore. Does Jonah not read his anymore either? I take it to heart. I really do. And I appreciate what you guys are saying, but I don't want to read. Like, I'm not going to read, like, building myself up on stream, you know? I appreciate you saying it all. Thank you guys for your kind words, but come on. Oh, that's awesome, Kirby. Secondhand high is better than no high. Yeah, yeah, I'm with that. Really, Yuri's Gold, you smoke weed before and didn't get you high? I've known people who've said that before. I've always been curious about that because I've smoked myself sober where I've been really high and then I smoked even more and then I was like, I don't feel high anymore. That's happened, which is probably just a mental thing because I was definitely high. I had smoked so much to where there's no way I wasn't. Yeah, but I don't know, dude. I like it. I like it. That's interesting. Yeah, people have said that before, like, their first time smoking weed, they didn't get high. I was like, man, really? My first time smoking weed, I got so blazed. Oh, I was so high. Annika, thank you very much. Yeah, right? Oh, I'm proud of you. That's awesome. Well, I guess that does make you high, Jill Ottaway. Just not in a way that is productive, maybe. I feel that. It's okay. Yeah, that happens, Alucard, I know. Hitting the pen is different than smoking real flower, too. It's just different. Integrity Farms! You guys seen that South Park? It's so funny. Meg, bunch of numbers, thanks again. Sure. It's all good. Hey, love you too. Nell, thanks again. Sure. I am tacky and I hate myself, sure. Not inhaling? Who's not inhaling? Well, that's why you're not getting high. I know, Strawberry Mermaid, me too. But sometimes the pen's all you got. No MBC02 Earthling. I did that because I'm a huge Carl Sagan fan, but also that song got written because I was, you know, really stoned and I was just verbally vomiting, as I call it, at my friends, and they were taking notes the whole time on their laptops. And then a week later, they showed up with everything that I had said in like lyric form. And I was like, bro, that's what we were talking about. He's like, yeah, dude, you were just like going off and it was awesome. So King of the Clouds became that. But I was talking about like quantum theory and 11th dimension and Carl Sagan and all this stuff and, you know, Schrodinger's cat and all that crap. And yeah, man. Thanks, Sugar Girl 90. If you could recommend anything for a first time smoker of weed, what would it be? I mean, I would say do a water pipe, a bong. That was like when the first times I got high, that got me so fucking high that it was overwhelming, and I think that you need that when you're smoking weed. Terrence McKenna says, if you're gonna do that drug, you should do it in heroic doses to where it scares you, to where you respect that drug. You understand? Like, he's a little wilder though, but that's mostly with just psychedelics and weed. And he would roll these things he called bombers before he took like salvia and like salvia divinorum and mushrooms and acid and all this stuff. Before he did any of that stuff, or DMT, before he did any of that stuff, he would roll these bombers, as he calls them. And when he would get really high, he would smoke these bombers and it would push him over the threshold of the next high. And they say with DMT that you need that. You need to smoke such an insane, like so powerfully and so quickly and like take it all in to where when you're blowing out the smoke that you're hitting that high and you're like into another dimension. But that was Terrence McKenna. He was also a scientist and just a genius. And He pontificated that we learned language from the females, the hominids that stood upright first. The females would go out and they would eat these mushrooms. And when you eat mushrooms, language doesn't really make sense. You're trying to figure out how to describe the images in your head to your friends, and language starts to appear in a different way. And you're using words with purpose, and you're trying to figure out sounds that describe the visions in your head. And that's where he says, that's where he theorizes that language came from. And I think that's a really cool thing. You know, I like to think that that is a possibility, that females of the species were eating these mushrooms and trying to describe what they were seeing in their heads. And I think that's a really cool idea. ED91800, thank you for the 1,000 bits. Thank you, Trishiri69. I've never done ayahuasca. That seems like a long time. Like 12 hours of being high and shitting and puking and... I don't know, man. Anyway, this got weird. I like reading that stuff, dude. I like watching those videos. Look up on YouTube, man. Just listen to Terrence McKenna pontificate. He would hold these seminars and these like meetings with other intellectuals, and they were curious to hear what he thought. And it was just like really cool stuff. Because he was a true scientist. He went, you know, straight on head first into this stuff. He just like was curious about all these psychedelics and just like didn't know what this world held. And he would just go full-fledged, what he called heroic doses, man. He was taking these heroic doses, and it's really cool. SamWow610, thank you so much. Oh no, that sucks. Oh no. Vera, thank you. Yeah, that's interesting, huh? Does it ever really get weird with the bros, though? I know, I feel that, Madison Case. Does it ever really get weird? Do we ever have that threshold that we're crossing? It's like too weird? Nah, dude, it's the bros. Oh, man. Emperor's New Vros. Read aloud, please. Okay. I've only got 5 days left on my gifted sub, so I would just like to say thank you to the Vros and B for being such an amazing community and supportive space for everyone. I appreciate these streams and the Vros more than anyone will ever know. Okay, I'm getting very teary typing this, but it has brightened my days a hell of a lot. Sending all my love to the Vros. I love you, Vros. Hey, we love you too, Emperor's New Vros. Great name, by the way. Steffi appreciates B. Thank you so much. So he got paid for getting really high. Kinda. He was a professor and a teacher and a, you know, he didn't get paid a lot, but yeah, people would pay him to talk about this stuff and to write books about this stuff. And he was just really good at it. And his voice is amazing. When he talks about all this, like I do a really bad Terrence McKenna, but listen to him talk, dude. Go to YouTube right now and type in Terrence McKenna and listen to him just pontificate about DMT, man. There's these 3-hour, 4-hour long videos, and you can just sit there in the dark and just listen to him meditate, bro. It's awesome. Steffi appreciates me. Thank you so much. Compliment warning. Okay, I'll read it. Thank you very much. I love you too. Thanks for saying that. Thanks, Cinepanic. Love you, Cinna. It's okay. Ich liebe dich. Ich liebe dich. Yeah, Terrence McKenna, he's got a great beard. Dude, he looks awesome. And he's really soft-spoken, and he does these things, and he's talking about... Dude, he's awesome, and he's so fun to listen to. Hello to your friend Samuel. What's up? Play a vid of him now? I guess I could. Asta Jepsen, thank you for the bits. It's a true weed Wednesday. Yeah, we're talking psychedelics, man. If you guys want to see Terrence McKenna, I'll show you a video of him right now. And mostly it's just his voice. Like, for the most part, you don't see him, really. But you hear him talking in these rooms. And, oh my god, my YouTube's gonna be so slow. It's been really bad lately since I got that ad blocker, so I hope this works. Maybe it won't. We'll see if this works. It's not working right now. It's being really slow. Artax, thank you for the bits. How you doing? Dope. Hi. Thank you, Artax. Yeah, it's not working, guys. My YouTube doesn't work anymore. Interesting. Okay. I'm curious why this is doing this. What, do you guys know why? With my ad blocker? I'm gonna look at my ad blocker real quick. Hold on. Let's open it up and let's do settings. And let's go. Let's take off some of the. Okay. Advanced settings. Okay, cool. No, it's fine. I just need to take off some of the settings, like, so we can watch this video together. Okay. There we go. I just had to change the ad blocker, guys. No worries. All right. Here we go. You guys want to watch the full screen thing, or do you care?
The substances that all through the ages have helped us alter our awareness, our perception of reality. Terence McKenna is a writer, a speaker, and in fact an activist. And what's your feeling when I say drugs?
Well, drugs is a word which has polluted the well of language. Part of the reason we have a drug problem
so
is because we don't have an intelligent language to talk about substances, plants, psychedelics, sedative states of mind, states of amphetamine, excitation.
Congrats, Rissy Blue. Thank you. Love you.
We can't make sense of the problem,
this is Terence McKenna.
The opportunities operated,
smart guy,
by substances, unless we clean up our language. Drugs is a word that's been used by governments to.
So let me stop real quick. This is a guy that took, like, one of the first people to talk about taking DMT in such an intelligent way that people started to listen. People that had never taken drugs, mind you, intellectuals, right? And he started to tell people that this is a dimension that we don't understand yet. And this is a train going a million miles an hour into a dimension we don't understand. And we're crossing that threshold. We need to understand more of it. We don't have the language in which to do that. He's the first guy to propose that, you know, DMT, his idea of it was like, you know, everybody says like there's these little elves working on geometric shapes around us. And that's what our world is made of. And you start to understand this thing and they're telling you, don't be overwhelmed. It's this whole thing. It's really great. He's just really,
make it impossible
really smart
to think creatively about the problem of substances and abuse and availability and so forth and so on.
Great, great voice.
In the minds of the people, the word drugs
the mindship to people
once used as healing medications, and still drug companies that make I don't know, Tylenol are considered very,
yes, Lars writes exactly.
Well, yes. So it's a kind of a paradox, isn't it? Drugs mean that which cures us and the greatest social problem of the generation. So there, right there, you see the schizophrenia involved in thinking about drugs. Apparently, there are good drugs sanctioned by science and medicine and bad drugs used by brown people in strange rites and growing.
He's so smart talking about this.
Usual plants in distant parts of the
world.
It's
the only reason we think bad about drugs.
This kind of
propaganda
thinking,
and shit,
because it's naive, leads, of course, to social problems and bad politics and bad social policy.
Yes, drugs unlock what's already inside of us.
Your sense has been to at least look for what you call those strange plants and strange substances in strange places. You have been, you originally were a botanist, or you still are.
Yes, and from the time I was very young, I was fascinated with the idea of extremely dramatic changes in consciousness,
right,
from which one recovers after a few hours, induced by plants.
That's what DMT is, because you can take DMT and have a trip for about 5 to 10 minutes and then immediately be out of it and be totally fine and go right to work. That's what's so interesting, is that you live and you're transported to a different dimension, but then you come back and you're like, oh, I'm back in reality. Okay. Your brain is so powerful. We know so little about it. And yet we've decided all these rules about drugs. It's so interesting to me. Anyway, that's Terence McKenna, guys. Look him up if you're really interested. He talks amazingly about amazing things. And just, it's really cool to hear him just pontificate about psychedelics and language and why we are who we are. Vera, thank you so much for the bits. Thank you, BL128. Yeah, man, that's how we do it. Yeah, the Joe Rogan video about DMT. That one's great. Can it hurt your body though? DMT? I'm pretty sure it's no, because you know what DMT is? Dimethyltryptamine. It's how you dream at night, guys. Your pineal gland, which is your third eye, okay? The only reason that you dream and don't go crazy and die is because of DMT. When you fall asleep and you go into REM sleep, rapid eye movement, you're in your deepest point of your sleep cycle. Your brain, your pineal gland, pumps out the DMT, which in turn makes you hallucinate and trip, and you have a trip, dude. It's called a dream. Your brain, your pineal gland pumps out the most of it right before you die. So when people say that they see God, their pineal gland is pumping out all of this DMT into your brain. So they're in between dream world and reality. They're still conscious and they're like, oh geez, I'm going to the light. I'm seeing my ancestor. I'm seeing all these people. They're greeting me. That's your brain pumping out the DMT, pineal gland pumping it out into your brain. Pretty crazy, huh? Every living thing has dimethyltryptamine in it, by the way. Grass, lizards. Lizards, actually, their third eye, their pineal gland, has a cornea and a lens. It's advanced, you know? Anyway. That's fun stuff. Great. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. Oh, my God. There you go, guys. There's your science lesson for the day. Deputy New Dallas, thanks for the 1,000 bits, you legend. Worked my ass off now, officially paid off all my student loans. Oh my God, congrats. That's huge, dude, seriously. Now I can now say, fuck you, bank. My degree belongs to me. That's so dope, Debbie. Big congrats to you. Jaina D, thank you so much. I'm glad you're feeling better. That's awesome. You guys know that? Every night, you guys are tripping on dimethyltryptamine, naturally. Every single night, every time you dream, you're doing drugs. Welcome to my TED Talk. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. Be Free 1971, thank you so much. Yeah, it's fun stuff, dude. Yep, everybody's tripping balls every night. Yeah, his name is Terrence McKenna. Terrence McKenna. Yeah, I smoke too much weed to trip too. Except that you do trip. You actually trip harder. And the reason you don't remember is because it was so overwhelming and devastating that your brain just goes, nope, we're not remembering that. We couldn't handle it. That's another thing too. You do dream every night when you smoke weed, but you don't remember them. You just don't remember them. Velvet Fright, thank you so much. Because if you didn't, you would go crazy and you would die. If you didn't dream. You didn't sleep, you didn't dream. Yes. Thank you, Michelle K. Oh, wow. Yeah, the idea of microdosing. That's a really cool thing. People do that all the time, and it's fine. You know, you can microdose mushrooms, and it's, like, really healthy for you. It actually helps people with post-traumatic stress disorder and depression and anxiety and all these affiliations with all that kind of stuff, you know? Thanks, GSP Freak. Why do we need to dream? Nobody can really answer that yet. Yep, that's right. We don't really know why we have to. We just know that we need to or else. Thanks again, GSP Freak. Turns into a psych lesson. It kind of is, huh? Sorry, y'all. Sorry, not sorry. I'm into psychology and quantum theory and all that stuff. I think it's very interesting. I'm interested in the stuff that we think we know because we really don't, dude. We know more about space than we do our own planet. How about that? We only know about 3% of the ocean. We've only been able to discover it. We can't even go that deep. We don't know what that sound is in the water that might be the biggest animal that has ever existed on the planet. We don't know. We don't know how to figure out how to get to it. We don't have the technology. Still, almost 2020. Guys, we still don't have that. Emma Rose, thank you so much. Hey, thanks. I hope you have an amazing day too. Thank you. What's up, guy? I feel that, Jenny Karina. I feel that. How do I know all of this? Because I watched YouTube videos. And I listen to podcasts and I smoke weed. I don't know. How does anybody know anything? I spend time learning it. Sister Discord, thanks for the 1,000 bits. Brain chemistry and you with Professor. Yeah, there's, how about this? We don't know what we don't know. I love that Neil deGrasse Tyson quote. We don't know what we don't know yet. And that, that frustrates me, but also excites me because there's endless possibilities. And it's just, I don't know, man. I love life. I love that there's so many possibilities. It's so cool. You don't know more than you know. You know what I mean? Like, you think you know all this stuff, but you don't know more stuff. Optimistic nihilism, that's awesome. Yeah. Parallel universes? Oh, I'm here for it. Let's talk about it. It's good stuff. Thanks, Meg Bunch of Numbers. And Polly, thank you. I'm not blowing any minds. Trust. Simply Marie, thank you for the bits. Yeah, that makes sense. Polly Cole, thank you. Hope you have a lovely day too. Thank you very much. Michelle MS13, thank you so much. Happy Wednesday. Oh, you're a psychology grad. Nice. Wow. Yeah, hope you have a wonderful day too. Thank you. Nell, thanks. Exactly. yeah, this could be that one. Stina, aka Havsty, thanks again. Yeah, that is weird. It's all because of racism, dude. It's the only reason that William Randolph Hearst and fucking J. Anslinger, Henry J. Anslinger, like, made it illegal because they were racist, dude. Like, how do we oppress the brown people? That's literally what happened. And they were like, okay, well, they smoked this thing called marijuana. So, well, let's just say that that's the evil drug that's going to make them take our white women and kill people. It's so stupid. Look it up, dude. Look it up. Anslinger. Look up all that shit. Early 1900s, why weed is illegal. Because it's a racist. Tony Panics ATD, thank you so much. Did everybody vote on the songs? You guys only have about 20 minutes left to do that. And then we're playing the songs, baby. And I'm gonna go get my hair cut. I know, Kirby, right? It's crazy. Show my hair. It's greasy and gross right now. But yeah, there you go. Gross. It's gross. Get it off. Get it off my head. Can't leave us on this mindset. All right, let's change it. Let's change it. Let's start talking about something else. Let's not leave like this. Yo, Swansea, what up, Jonah? I know, huh? Not gonna lie. I read that in your voice, Jonah. That's awesome. I know, huh? Not gonna lie. What up, bro? Nah, you guys will see my haircut. Maybe tomorrow. Wait, what do I have tomorrow? I don't know if I'm gonna stream. Wait, I think I can. Hold on. I have stuff going on. Okay. We might be able to do a morning one tomorrow. And then... Oh, shit. I don't know if I'll be able to do Friday, guys. I don't know if I'll be able to stream Friday, so... Heads up and apologies ahead of time. Is that why I'm in a hat? Yeah, I just don't want greasy hair on my face, dude. And I'm getting a haircut. I have to go wash it, and then I'm going to get it cut. It's all good, dude. How do we vote? Click on that straw poll link and go vote. Homo at the disco, thanks for the bits. Yeah. That's awesome. Great combo. Hey, thanks, Homo at the disco. Appreciate that. That's cool. You're a philosophy major. I love that stuff. I love philosophizing, dude. It's fun. Why don't you go somewhere they wash it for you? Someone is actually coming to my house. Casual flex. Weird flex, dude. Nell, thank you. Don't come back then. Jeez. All right. Fine. I won't. Fine. Oh, no. School starts on Monday? Really? Is summer break already over? That was quick. Holy shit. Thanks, Nell. Do I believe in paranormal? No, let's say I believe in it. That's... I don't like to throw around the word belief. I believe in myself. I believe in the bros. I don't believe in ghosts. Nah. I believe in possibilities of stuff rather than believing wholeheartedly in something that... Yeah. Anyway. Yeah, yeah. Thanks, Michelle MS13. I don't know if we do international, to be honest with you. It depends. If you've, like, prepped the letters and stuff, maybe. Thank you, Vera. What's that? Sugar Girl 90, thank you. Oh, dope, dude. I feel that. Much love to you. Word. Polly, thank you. That's a great one. Yeah, come on. I'm here for the booty. Thanks, B128. Thanks. Julie Jackson, thank you. Happy birthday, Leah. Thanks, Fran Favell. Oh, thanks. I'm sorry. That is sad bits, but I appreciate you. Yeah, let's get high and watch Pete play to the wall. Strawberry, let's do it. I don't know, aesthetically, Ashley. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to trim it. I just want to get the hair shorter. That's my goal. That's all I'm asking for. I'm not going to, you know, no, I don't know. All this stuff, a fade, a disconnect, I don't know. I'm just going to say, cut it. Shorten it, dude. Thanks, Meg Bunch of Numbers. Of course, dude. Much love to you, my bros. Get a fade and a perm. Okay, now. What do you think they did? Oh, man. Get an army haircut? Dude, nah. My head shape is interesting and unique. And with like a buzzed head, I look so not good. Kate, thanks for the bits. Yeah. I mean, I think there's an activation happening, something that is opening new that was a part of your brain all along. That's what I think. But yeah, there could be a combination of also influence from this other substance. Alyssa TO513, thank you so much. Wave check. Hell yeah, brother. Sugar Girl 90, thank you. Color it pink and permit. Nah, dude, come on. All right, maybe. Masha, thank you. Dope. Yeah, that's my Nashville home. Imagine I went bald. Well, dude, I'm getting older every day. Could happen. At any moment, this could all just fall away. And that's okay, because that's natural. That's fine. Don't worry about it, guys. One day I'll be 50 years old. I'll be like, where did it all go? Where did all the time go? All right, Bear, thank you for the bits. Would you ever do customs with the subscribers? Yeah, I would, but it doesn't work anymore. Remember it just stopped working one day? That sucked. We haven't been able to do that in months. Yeah. What's up? Pink cat music. I mean, I love a minor four chord. Oh. A minor four in a major scale. You know, if we're playing in C major, let's say, and I play an F minor in there. Ooh. Ooh. You know? If you go C to A minor to F major to F minor. Ah. My favorite pre-resolve. My favorite tension. Queen Polly, thank you so much. It's like that part in Layla. That kind of thing. There's an Insta page where they edit all your pics and make you bald. Oh, really? Interesting. Blair the Disco, thank you for the bits. The floof will remain. Yeah, we'll see once I get it cut. I mean, it stays floofy, you know? And once it gets shorter, actually, it gets more floofy because it has less weight to it. Has less hair pulling it down and greasifying it. Thanks, Claire Gillespie. What is playing right now? It's like freaking me out. Sugar Girl 90, thank you. Just got a toner, a musical boner? Yes, I did. Dude, a minor four in a major scale? Or you do a major three, dominant seven? In a C major, you play the E7 chord? E major seven? It's so good. I love that. Exactly, Pink Cat Music. That's what I'm saying. Adding that weird sixth. What up, Swans? Oh, man. Yeah, dude. Yep. That's a great one. Panic Devotee, thank you so much. No, you won't, Pedroke B01. Pedroke B01 goes, someday I'll touch your hair. Ha, ha, ha. It's a restraining order. Nope. Please don't touch my hair. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thanks for gifting the sub. Put your little sticky fingers all over my hair. Nell, thank you. fix your custom so I can insult you in person. Dude, I wish. I don't know how to fix it. Sugar Girl 90, thank you. Ooh, nice. That's me, dude. BeFree 1971, thank you so much. All right. Hey, thanks for hanging. We'll see you later. All right, guys. Like 8-10 more minutes and we'll start playing the songs. Let's see what won. I think we know what won, right? Fedra, thank you for the bits. You can. You just have to read about it or watch a video about it. Dude, there's YouTube tutorials for all of that stuff. Anybody can learn all this stuff. That's what's great about the internet. Yeah, Emma. Please don't fuck my wife and please don't touch my hair. That Chris Mellenberger and Jay Cyrus video. Oh my God. And please don't fuck my wife. That's so funny. Yeah, Killer Queen Crush, I bet. I love that song. We used to cover that, you guys know. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. Yo, welcome, Vrohemian Rhapsody, to the Vro Chat. What's up, hey? What's up? Thanks, Michelle MS13. I do watch Friends. Yeah, the Thanksgivings are hilarious. I don't know. The Christmas ones are great. The Christmas Armadillo is really funny. I don't know, man. Like, season 6 and 7 just kind of crushed it, right? Ari Bear, thank you so much. I know, but I couldn't figure it out. You know, and I have a custom code, but for some reason, I think because I encouraged Stream Snipers that they, like, stopped me from doing customs, which doesn't make any sense. I don't know. What up? I love The Office, dude. Great show. Of course. Cedra Erson, you don't clap, you snap. What do you mean? It's that. That's the intro. Moeshano. It snaps, baby. Foxycano 09, thank you so much. Yeah, I love Whataburger, dude. It's only in Texas, though. I remember the first time we were in Dallas. We drove past a Whataburger. We're like, what's that? Let's go try it. We tried it. It was amazing. I'm like, dude, this is dope. I love a Whataburger, bro. I'll snap with you, Cedra. I'll snap with you. All right. Oh, my God. I still have pia pia in my eye. Yep, yeah. You have Whataburger in Arizona? Oh, they branched out, dude. That's so dope. What's up? Hello. Oh no. You can't eat it every day. You can't eat Whataburger every day. Unless you're like running 10 miles every day. I mean, woof, that'll catch up to me. Woof. Giselle, thanks for the bits. Wow, nice. That's awesome. Oh, that's cute, Kirby. Yeah, that's very similar. Oh, what about Seinfeld, dude? Love Seinfeld. Come on. One of my favorite shows ever. Remember the hot tub episode with Kramer? Oh my god, dude. So good. With the runner, and he's like late for the marathon. Blair the Disco, thank you so much for the bits. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, hopefully. I think I would. Foxy Cano, thank you. Oh, I don't remember. I honestly can't remember my order. It was so long ago. I haven't had it in a long time. It's been years. We don't have one by me, so it's been years since I had one. Oh my god, the puffy shirt episode, the pirate shirt. Oh my god, it's so good. A good show. So yeah, dude, the Soup Nazi, classic. Classic. Where Kramer's a pimp. Are you a pimp? Dude, it's so good. Oh my god. The one where they get spit on at the baseball game by Hernandez. By Hernandez, dude. It's so good, bro. Oh my god. I do synatexia, of course. Means prince. Sarah's means princess. I know this. Yeah, the baseball game. Oh yeah, Freaks and Geeks is a great show. It's James Franco, man. Seth Rogen. It's, oh my god. That's so good. All right, guys. A few more minutes. We're going to start these songs. These ending songs. We're going to end this stream. Yeah, Jason Segel. So good. That's right. He's really into Rush, and he's got the, like, the 29-piecer or whatever. It's a 29-piecer. 26. What does he say? It's a 29-piecer. The drum kit. Oh, my God. That's so funny. Meg Bunch of Numbers. Thank you. That's awesome. That's cool, Meg. Thank you. Yo, shout out to your brother, Jeremy. What's up, dude? I'm about to get my hair cut just like you, Jeremy. Cindy Banal, thank you. Thanks, Anis4444. You amazing, dude. You amazing. So amazing. What's up? I do, Freya Marie. I do like pickles. Not with everything. Not necessarily on their own, but yeah, I fuck with pickles. Dude, Chick-fil-A without a pickle is not Chick-fil-A. You understand? What's up? Hey. Boogie. Uh-huh. Mr. Morningstar? Oh, dude, Morningstar. We talking about the fake meat stuff? So high in sodium, man. We used to eat that stuff all the time. The Morningstar ribs and stuff. Vera, thank you so much. Of course. Was it super educating, informative today? I'm glad. All about psychedelics and possible interdimensional parallel universes. Killer Queer, thanks for the bits. Well, thanks. That's awesome. Thanks for going. That's blasphemy, Stephanie C. What up? Hello. Welcome. Kind of drum sets behind me. It's a DW, baby. DW. Meg Bunch of Numbers, thank you so much. We also use SJC a lot, mostly for tour. Love both those companies. Of course. Yeah, of course. That's just sibling shit. I know, Rally Casey. That's how I feel. You gotta pick one. You can only vote for one. That can only be one. What is up? Yeah, man. Wait, what, Sidra? I forgot what you asked, to be honest. I forgot what you mentioned. Talking about your devil ass, but sure. I don't even remember what you said, honestly. It was a minute ago. My brain can't retain it. I'm a stoner, bro. Short-term memory and all that, you know? All right, guys. Let's start playing these songs. We know what won. We already been knew what won. And we been knew. Let me just look at the results just to be totally sure so I don't fuck it up. Oh, dude, it won by so much. Double the votes. And you know we're doing it, man. Come on. Please. Just hurry up and work, you know? Spotify, you're so slow. Okay, here we go. Jeez, you know? All right.
She keeps them always on the in a mini cabinet. Cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette.
Khrushchev and Kennedy. Thanks, Polly. Guaranteed. Recommended at the price. Appetite. Wanna try. Wanna try. Thanks, Killer Queer. I know. This drum fill, though. I love that. Can't leave you that way inclined. Naturally from Paris. Fastidious and precise. She's a killer. Oh, the harmonies, though. Dynamite with a laser beam. Guaranteed to blow your mind. So beautiful. I love a solo you can sing. We used to cover this, man, on our circus tour. I remember I had to do the guitar solo. It's so funny. And I'm so bad at guitar. Thanks, Sugar Girl 90. Drop of a hat, Jesus really gets playful. Momentarily out of action, temporarily out of action. Absolutely trying. Panic vs. Streets with Man Himself, Dan. Hell yeah! Thanks, Blair. Wanna try. Man. So crazy. The tone, right? The Brian May tone. It's ridiculous. This is it, y'all. I love you. Thank you for hanging out with me and being such dope people. You're beautiful. You're amazing. Believe in yourself. Learn to love yourself. Tell yourself that every day in the mirror. Look at you and say, hey, you're worth it. Now go try something. I love you. We love you too, Jonah.
Sometimes it's bad, sometimes it's good. You broke our love,
fucking
like
knew you would.
But there was something about your smile. I had to be there by your side.
Thanks, Nell. Have a lovely day. Get a fun haircut. It'll be so basic.
You're like the needle in my heart.
Yeah, Kirby. Thank you, Paw Dog, for the 3,000. Love you. Thank you so much.
I can barely see you light.
Thanks, Vera. Love you. Thank you so much. Thanks, Vanya. See ya.
You're my drug.
My gasoline.
Wrapped in a world of
make-believe.
Cause there was something about your smile. I had to be there by
look at all the love, dude. I love you guys. Thanks for hanging, as always. Yeah, Kate. Thank you. This is called Carol by Foray Devin.
Cause it's a
hard life for us. Nothing I can do about it. Thanks, Nocturnal Muse. Thank you for the 1,000. Thank you, Jenny Sunshine. Love you guys. Yeah, of course. Y'all hate the Carol bitch. Francis Richard, thank you so much. Love you. Alice 94 Crazy, thank you so much. See you tomorrow. Lisa Schler. Thank you, Nell.
We can never look back. We're in the eye of the storm.
Thanks, Meg. Bunch of numbers.
Where did we go wrong? Ooh.
Yeah, dude. Thanks, Alexis,
what
at the disco.
All
right, I'll see you later. Have a good one.
I'm all alone. Save me from the snowstorm.
Yeah. I love you guys. Thanks, Vera. Thank you, Candy SP. See you later. Leslie Chain 420, appreciate you. Oh, happy birthday to you, your daughter. That's awesome. Oh my God. Isn't that the best? Isn't that just the best way to end a stream with the Vros? Listen, I love you all. I appreciate you. Thank you so much for existing. And as always, remember how dope you are. All right, you freaking legends. I'll see you guys later. Have the rest of a beautiful day. Make it worthwhile. You're beautiful. You're awesome. You're worth it. And I'll see you later. Okay, guys. See you tomorrow. Bye.